Welcome, everyone. I have a few announcements before we begin the graduation ceremony. You will see the seniors walking around the stadium. Please remain seated until you hear Pomp and Circumstance played by our orchestra. At the conclusion of the ceremony, please use both the left and the right to exit. Finally, please silence all electronics at this time. Thank you. Thank you.
Please be seated. Good evening, graduates, parents, friends, faculty, administration, and the members of the Downingtown Board of Education. Welcome to the 137th annual Downingtown High School commencement ceremony and the Downingtown STEM Academy's fifth. Class of 2018, as a member of this class, I proudly stand here with you to celebrate our accomplishments. Tonight, we honor a dedicated and outstanding faculty that has given countless hours to us and our school community. Tonight, we honor each of you sitting here in the stands who have supported our seniors over the past 18 years. Tonight, we celebrate and pay tribute to the years of hard work and effort of our 194 graduates. This year, the senior class was asked to read and reflect on concepts from the poem Human Beings Being Human by Joe Flack. In conjunction with countless academic achievements, we are good at being human. Allow me to share the poem with you. You can follow along in your programs. Human beings being human. It would be great if human beings were great at being human, and if all of mankind were made up of kind men. It would be wonderful if common knowledge was knowledge commonly known, and if the light from being enlightened into every heart was shown. It would be fantastic if the war to end all wars was the last war that we fought. It would be amazing if we learned the lessons from every lesson we were taught. It would be cool if our freedom to us was freely granted, and if every seed of kindness would grow wherever planted. It would be glorious if neighbors were neighborly and prejudice a forgotten word. It would be awesome if we shared everything and being greedy was absurd. It would be spectacular if the golden rule was golden to every man and the good things that we did was everything that we can.
Good evening. Our first commencement speaker founded the STEM Academy's TEDx Club during her freshman year and successfully co-hosted two TEDx events. She is an executive member of the National Honor Society, a member of the Spanish Honor Society, and a member of Student Council. Next year, she will attend the University of Pittsburgh Honors College for Business, where she will major in international healthcare management. And this summer, she will study in Dublin, Ireland on a Woodcock Global Honors Fellowship. The experience will include interacting with executives with different companies such as Google, Facebook, and LinkedIn. No doubt she will continue to use her wit and charisma to be a successful human being. Please help me welcome to the stage Alexandra McCurdy.
As many of you know, I'm obsessed with TED Talks. Now, if only I had a giant red carpet, we could make this really official. But instead, I stand before you today amid a sea of blue and gold. Congratulations to you all. It would be great if we could remember each moment here, our time together as the class of 2018. It would be even better if our memories drove our actions and we could share those with others and they'd understand. But it would be the best if we could reflect on what makes us the best class in the history of the Downingtown STEM Academy. So I decided I'd take some time to share with those who may not know or may have forgotten some of what makes the class of 2018 so special. And just maybe the underclassmen out there can learn a thing or two. For one, we worked hard. With creative usage of time management, which in some cases could be called procrastination, some of us developed the ability to complete great workloads at great speeds, such as 50 plus history content terms or 4,000 words of an EE, especially with our high-speed laptops, manage-back technology, and advanced Wi-Fi capabilities. Sometimes we talked out our problems, or RLSs, and guided by a well-constructed KQ, we energetically explored claims and counterclaims with AOKs and WOKs until a conclusion was reached, and we were doing it all over again. Then we lost. The way we were able to accept such failure during the Powder Puff season humbled our spirit and made us stronger. I think losing united our class in a way that no normal, average win could have ever done. People often say they find STEM to be a community. Well, I find our class to be more of a family. Oh, sorry, I guess that should be an ecosystem, especially since we took that day to recover after we underwent a secondary succession with an abiotic response to environmental stimuli. And of course, we laughed. We laughed with teachers, custodians, admin, Mr. Bill, and each other. Frankly, STEM and the IB became memes. And if you didn't get the joke, well, it seemed more like a prank. Just not as sad as our attempt to organize a senior prank. After reading Joe Flack's poem, and annotating it, of course, using the smile technique, I came to a realization. As humans, we all have our faults and are challenged to meet our desired potential. Yet, when I compared these ideals to those of STEM students, I realized that we are different. We understand world problems, and we don't just sit in class and do nothing. We take on the IB learner profiles and are open-minded thinkers that are principled risk-takers who communicate and care to be knowledgeable and reflective inquirers in a balanced lifestyle. Did I get all of them? Did you get all of them? Whether you realize it or not, these characteristics of the class of 2018 are what Joe Flack is looking for in the world. So that what we say is what we mean, and what we do is what we see, and what we want is what we achieve. Once we walk off this field, where once upon a time games of mat ball were being played, our lives will change forever. We will no longer have to worry about getting to school on time for a parking space, or worry about whether to use .stem or @student emails. No, our worries will supersede the four walls of the academy, and create personal interactions with real-life situations. But haven't they already? I know most of you believe that we are living in a bubble where the only wars are wars on cupcakes, and the only struggle for freedom is a struggle for a collab room and the right to print double-sided. A bubble so small, we will not be prepared to step outside of it. Yet I believe our class, the class of 2018, will pop that bubble full force and be the humans that will make the world our bubble, for better or for worse. As has been stressed, this ceremony is not for us students. No, this is for our parents, our teachers, and our supporters. It's for them to see what should make up the future generation and to learn what characteristics have made us willing and prepared to make a difference in our community, our country, and our world. Our journey over the last few years of STEM have been for us. So while it would be great to remember all our time here, especially those difficult times that we grew from, I just hope that you remember that this journey has made you who you are today, a graduate of one of the best public high schools in the state and an IB learner ready to take on the world. Through all of this, I truly believe I found myself an HL family in the class of 2018. Thank you.
Every year, the Downtown Area High School Alumni Association presents a prestigious scholarship to one student from each high school in the district. This scholarship is presented to honor these selected students for showing commitment to their school and community through extracurricular activities and leadership roles. Founded over 130 years ago, the Downtown High School Alumni Association is the oldest continually operating alumni association in the country and continues to uphold education and scholarship. Our speaker today is a pillar of the Downtown community, serving as the vice president of the Alumni Association. She graduated from Downtown Senior High School, Westchester University, and currently teaches music at Downtown Area School District Elementary Schools. Please give a warm round of applause to Miss Angela Bayer.
Thank you. And congratulations to the class of 2018 from Downingtown STEM. As you heard, our Alumni Association is recognized as one of the oldest active alumni associations in the nation. We were founded in 1884. The Alumni Association has supported and continues to support a variety of activities to honor our students and alumni. Some of this support includes sponsoring the annual homecoming programs at all three Downingtown high schools. We sponsor the Battle of the Brandywine, which is our rivalry football game between Downingtown East and Downingtown West each year. We host and support the Downingtown Area School District's Hall of Fame, and we provide the scholarship that you heard about that goes to one student at each of our three high schools. As a new graduate this year, you will automatically become a member of the Alumni Association for 1 year. For some of you, this may be the last year that you reside within the boundaries of our Downingtown Area School District. For others, you may end up returning and raising your own families here. If you decide in your future that you return to our good neighbor community, I would like to invite you to join our Alumni Association. Again, congratulations to all of you. Now it gives me great pleasure to present this $2,500 scholarship to Haley Shaw.
Many of us graduating today are 18, meaning we are officially adults, and as adults, we have to make many choices regarding our future. Three of us have made an honorable and brave commitment to serve our country as part of the United States Armed Forces. At this time, I would like to recognize these three students not only for their decision to serve our country in the United States Armed Forces, but also for their decision to do so with such conviction now. Please stand and remain standing when I call your name. Reed Boudry, United States Air Force Academy. Akash Damle, Penn State University Air Force ROTC. Gina Pereno, United States Naval Academy. I would also like to ask all of our guests who are currently serving or who have served in the United States Armed Forces to please stand so that we can thank you for your service. Thank you, you may be seated.
Good evening, my name is James Armstrong. Congratulations, class of 2018, on this momentous occasion. As we explore life beyond STEM, we can attribute much of our success to Ms. Susan Boardman, the internships and partnerships leader at the Downingtown STEM Academy. Her passionate and constant efforts have enabled us to embrace our motto, effort creates intelligence, by engaging in extensive career development outside of the classroom. Under Ms. Boardman's prudent guidance and excellent connections, each of us have had exciting practicum experiences in our areas of interest. I saw a behind-the-scenes view of how car dealerships operate, from sales to service to marketing. I learned that it takes the collaboration of a diverse team of hardworking employees to make a dealership successful. Drawing from experience rather than theory alone, I was able to channel this into DECA competitive wins and scholarships. Like many of my classmates, I selected my college and course of study because of these experiences. All this was possible with inspiration from Ms. Boardman's commitment to our class and promotion of our passions. As a senior in high school Ms. Boardman did not know where her journey would take her, but she remained true to her passions and used her skills of networking and communication to attain success. She began college as an architecture major because it encompassed her interest in math, physics, and art. However, soon realized that this path was not a good fit. Her enduring interest in design, though, enabled her to sharpen her skills in business development by working with architecture and design firms. Ms. Boardman never lost sight of her passions throughout her career and encourages us to do the same. Now, most important to Ms. Boardman is providing tools for the youth to enable them to pursue their passions. She championed that mission through her involvement with the Chester County Chamber of Commerce in the Youth Leadership Program and the Exton Chamber of Commerce in the Business Education Partnership. These tremendous experiences, coupled with her unparalleled passion, have prepared Ms. Boardman very well for her current work at the Downingtown STEM Academy. Every day, it is obvious how much she loves what she does. She teaches us the soft skills, such as collaboration, connection, and empathy, that make the difference in our interactions and help us stand out among our peers. She arranges for a multitude of on-site experiential learning from professionals, such as our visit to the Exelon Energy Trading Room last summer. And most importantly, she has helped us realize how to engage our passions and has given us a path to pursue them effectively. To succeed in our journeys, Ms. Boardman, like other great leaders, encourages us to ask for opportunities and take some risks along the way. Our generation is tasked with the responsibility of defining our future world. Ms. Boardman has provided the bridge between our learning at STEM and our entry into the world to help shape that future. I can confidently say that we are ready to make a difference because of Ms. Boardman. Ms. Boardman, would you please stand to be recognized? On behalf of the administration and all of the members of the class of 2018, I would like to thank you for your exceptional service and honor you with the Downingtown STEM Academy Recognition of Distinction. Thank you.
Good evening. Our next speaker will be attending the University of South Carolina's Capstone Program, majoring in business. While at the Academy, she played a major role in the establishment of the Downingtown Dance Team, helped to lead Shadow Day and Freshman Orientation, served on the National Honor Society Executive Council, was an international DECA finalist, and was a four-year member of the Student Council. In addition, her organizational and management talents were put to the test as she ran the 2018 Mr. STEM program, which raised $3,500 for Chester County Hero Fund. Please welcome our next commencement speaker, Morgan Michalski.
Thank you. Even if you face the world with kindness every day, sometimes it feels as though the world does not treat you in that same way. You may give your all to a person, a goal, a dream, and not reach it in the end. Flack talks about how it would be spectacular if the golden rule was golden to every man. Or, in other words, how great it would be if everyone believed in the basic principle of treating others the way that you want to be treated. And if that included a plethora of acts of kindness. He seems slightly frustrated with the lack of kindness that human nature holds, stemming from the fact that that is not how life really works. This reminded me of a story from my childhood. Everyone can recall that one infatuation they had when they were young. For me, it was butterflies. My room was plastered with yellow butterfly decorations from floor to ceiling. Butterflies adorned my book bag, my lunchbox, and every elementary school folder I owned. So, for my sixth birthday, when my parents surprised me with a trip to a butterfly conservatory, I was ecstatic. Filled with anticipation and excitement, I ran around in awe of the amazing array of butterfly species, trying desperately to touch just one of the magical butterflies fluttering overhead. For what seemed like an eternity, I wished for it to happen, but it seemed as though every butterfly flew to my brother instead. There was no way that 6-year-old me would have recognized this, but I now realize that even though you may want something more than anyone else, it does not mean that it will be handed to you. This is what I believe Flack was feeling as he wrote about the kindest of humans not being treated in the same way, not receiving that basic golden rule. This is definitely one lesson that we have learned through our 4 years here at the Downingtown STEM Academy. Life is not always easy. Things don't always come to us quickly. All of us sitting here today chose a path that we knew would challenge us. Sometimes the things we want the most, getting into the college of our dreams, a powder puff win, sleep, we just don't get. But it is how we face adversity that shows our true colors. By helping each other see the light in our darkest of moments, we are made stronger individually and as a community. The memories made painting jeans in a park and tearing it up at every school dance outshine even the most stressful of times. Flack writes, "It would be glorious if neighbors were neighborly and prejudiced a forgotten word." In our little community, with our neighbors, we have been successful at reaching that goal and learning to love and respect one another. Through every march, walkout, and history debate, we learn to respect another's opinions on even the most controversial of topics. He also wrote about how great it would be if we could all meet compassion with compassion. In my opinion, what really makes a person great, what makes the class of 2018 so special, is not only how we meet compassion, but also how we respond to hardship. As a class, we do what Flack wishes all of humanity would. For the past 4 years, any type of hardship that has come our way has been met with understanding, respect, and kindness. I hope that is how you continue to meet any adversity you face for the rest of your lives. After waiting not so patiently all those years ago, a worker at the conservatory came up to me and offered me some meaningful advice. She told me that butterflies are attracted to the people who wear the brightest of colors and stand the stillest. So, after all that time, sitting as still as I possibly could, I got to experience one of the most memorable moments of my childhood. A single yellow butterfly landed on my shoulder. Just as Flack discussed, planting seeds of kindness, sometimes things take time to develop. He's referring to invoking change in a person or society by slowly helping them grow into something better. But a more compassionate personality is not the only thing that can be developed over time. The butterflies did not come to me right away. Reaching a level of understanding does not come to people right away. And our dreams aren't always achievable right away. But if you learn to take a breath and wait, sometimes these things will come. So this is it, my dudes. As we continue our journey into the next phase of our lives, take the advice I learned so many years ago. Be bright. Be a positive force for our future. Show your true colors and have fun in life. But also, stand still. Be steadfast in your beliefs. Be willing to pause long enough to take in all of life's beauty. Continue to be more than just human. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. As a member of the Downingtown Music Program for as long as I can remember, I am proud to introduce the Downingtown STEM Academy Orchestra today. This past year marked Ms. Stephanie Gonzalez's second year as orchestra director, but in these few short years, her passion for music and dedication to her students has allowed this orchestra to flourish. And tonight, they'll play Point Lookout by Brian Balmages.
Mr. Brian Lloyd has been the Academy's choir director since the beginning of STEM. He's one of the reasons behind the guitar strumming, piano playing, and melodious voices that come from our school basement. Every time I see him in the hallways, I know that I can always be greeted with a big smile and a positive attitude. He helped pave the musical path in STEM by hosting STEM's first ever radio show, Rex Stu Radio, and by freely allowing his students to use his guitars to encourage their passions in music. The Downingtown STEM Academy would not be complete with our wonderful choir director. Under his direction, the STEM Academy Choir will perform Home with Words and Music by Drew Pearson and Greg Holden, arrangement by Greg Gilpin, and recording by Philip Phillips. I'm also proud to announce that the choir will be accompanied by the band Elastic Blur. Members of whom include Vishal Ramola and three of our very own STEM Academy graduating seniors, Patrick Bobko, Jack Flannery, and Remy Roskin. Elastic Blur is a modern rock group formed in the summer of 2015 that has a full-length album out on most streaming services, and they're currently working on their second. Please enjoy the performance of STEM Choir and Elastic Blur. Thank you.
Thank you. was wonderful. Thank you. Good evening and congratulations, graduates. It is my honor tonight to introduce our next speaker, the recipient of the President's Volunteer Service Award and an FBLA two-time national finalist, chapter officer, regional secretary, and state reporter. This young lady thrives in leadership roles. And this graduate is an excellent example of balance, excelling in areas of STEM and the arts, providing a continuous positive attitude and problem-solving mentality to everything she does. She's enjoyed playing the violin for the STEM orchestra and has taken on various leadership roles, serving as the founder and head of communications on the world-qualifying robotics team. And this is only the beginning for her. Next year, this distinguished student will attend the Wharton School of Business at the University of Pennsylvania. Please join me in welcoming Meghana Chigarapati.
...720 days of school, 194 students, 34 IB courses, 4 Powderpuff participation awards, 3 weeks of IB exams, 1 failed senior skip day. Class of 2018, we made it. As we look back at the last 4 years, they consisted of ups and downs. From cramming content terms the night before they were due, to dancing the night away at prom. We did it all together. And that's what makes us so special, our propensity to always be there for one another. In his poem, Human Beings Being Human, Joe Flack idealizes a world in which humans are kind, enlightened, and generous. By these standards, I can say that we were pretty awesome at being human. In fact, if this was a paper one and you had to analyze the characterization of the class of 2018, we would be defined by our kindness, generosity, and enlightenment. To quote the poem, the good things that we ever did was everything that we can. As a class, we were always willing to go the extra mile to make someone else's life a little better. Just this past year, students organized, ran, and participated in a camathon that raised over $88,000 for childhood cancer. And even though we may have procrastinated a bit, we all pulled through with CAS and graduation projects that ranged from food drives to hurricane relief to special needs advocacy. Even though we may have had kindness weeks throughout our tenure at the STEM Academy, we are part of a growing effort to turn them into lifetimes of compassion. In Flack's words, it would be wonderful if the light from being enlightened into every heart was shown. Over our 4 years here, we've been always encouraged by our teachers to be insightful and open-minded, and our ability to take what we learn and apply it outside of the classroom expressed just that. As we learned about the power of youth activism during the civil rights movement, we were able to realize our own potential, leveraging our voices to raise awareness for school safety through our walkout. Never forget the power each of you yield as long as you remain enlightened. Finally, we lived out the aspirations of Joe Flack as he dreamt of a world where generosity was expected and common knowledge was knowledge commonly known. I mean, it was a little hard to escape this as we sat in the knowledge commons. Our senior class was always eager to share what we know with one another as we try to beat each other out by making the Google Doc first. Also, quick tip, don't say, "I'll make the Google Doc" in college. It's probably something you should leave in high school. But on a more serious note, carry your generosity with you into all of your future endeavors. It's what makes you stand out, and it'll help you grow as a person. Now, as we grab our diplomas and shed our caps and gowns, we're faced not with an end, but rather a beginning, as a new door opens for us to travel on our own paths. No matter where you end up or what you choose to do, never forget our time here together. Take all that we've learned from every lesson we were taught and face the future with bright eyes, open minds, and a hunger to do more. With that, I would like to thank all of those who we could not have gotten here without. As Joe Flack says, it would be cool if our freedom to us was freely granted. To our teachers and administration, thank you for trusting us and granting us this freedom to creatively express ourselves. To our family and friends, thank you for your endless encouragement. And finally, to my fellow students, thank you for being the kindest group of humans. I could not be prouder to say that I was a part of this family. Thank you, and congratulations again to the class of 2018.
One evening last September, I found myself sitting on my couch with my laptop as my kids completed homework, played, and watched television. Filtering through my paperwork, I heard a compelling piece of poetry in a commercial. I focused on the words and the message lingered. I envisioned a world I want for my own children as well as yours. Joe Flack's thoughtful words in the poem, Human Beings Being Human, stuck. Fast forward to months later, I stopped to reflect on the personality and accomplishments of this class. Like all graduating classes, class of 2018, you are unique. Yes, you've mastered rigorous instruction, countless IB exams, and hours of service, along with jobs, clubs, organizations, and sports, all while maintaining balance. With the same level of importance, though, you share the bond of a family peppered with humor and passion. You see the good in life, an opportunity to better the world, and you have acted on both. You're enjoyable to be around and easy to respect. You reinvigorate my optimism of the future. Impressively, you already excel at being human. As adults, we try to share with students the importance of being kind. Kindness seems so simple, and yet our world just isn't. We begin to and attempt to instill kindness in children beginning at a very young age. And yet we must continue to remind ourselves and each other of its importance. Along with the challenging academics in our school, we make efforts to practice being human. These students do it with and without our instruction. They are quick to provide a kind word, a few moments of guidance to rework a problem, or a comforting snack whenever needed. They refuse to allow suffering in silence or isolation, and they always, without fail, offer a smile. From helping to raise over $88,000 for Cure for CAM, to collecting over 2,200 cans for the Student Council and NHS food drives, to learning to crochet scarves for St. Christopher's Hospital for Children, to baking thousands of cupcakes for Cradles to Crayons, and countless other and less publicized efforts. They are kind. Education should function today as a solution to a multitude of problems. This group of young people seeks enlightenment. Their knowledge is wide and vast. They can speak articulate on countless topics of interest and research. They can T-O-K just about anything with skill and zest. From our esteemed nationally ranked poet to state-ranked FBLA competitors and officers, to DECA and TSA national finalists, to model UN awards, to HOSA leadership conferences, to speech and debate honors, to masterminding the first LEGO League robotics team for students with special needs, this class exhibits knowledge and shares that with the world. So many other honors and awards were given to members of this class for their intellect and effort during the 4 years, but it is the everyday established common knowledge that they share that sets them apart. The reliance on logic and ration helps to drive their problem-solving attitudes towards application of knowledge and not just knowing. When they leave the walls of this institution, they see ways to improve and use their knowledge for betterment of those around them. They are knowledgeable. They continue to fight for battles for logic, justice, and freedom of thought, and wrestle with seemingly impossible problems. These students do just that, not on the sidelines, though they can be found there supporting at any given time, but also on center stage at the microphone and organizing just behind the scenes. And they will continue to shine humbly in the spotlight, showcasing their appeals and talents as we cheer them on. They don't necessarily seek out attention, but they don't shy away from opportunity to lead. and their leadership is valued based on the lessons that they have learned. This group does not always agree, but in disagreements, they are civil and remarkably alert, with minds open and hearts receptive to differing views. The lessons these students have learned far exceed the lessons the curricula have taught. They find peaceable solutions to real issues. They are fantastic. This class is an exemplar of kindness, and they are willing to share this skill. Their kindness is cultivated wherever they go. They complete CAS experiences, but their service of kindness goes far beyond any school requirements. They grow kindness even when they are in the heat of competition, when building robots for aggressive national championships, or creating impressive art while avoiding the dangers of a blowtorch. They grow kindness by organizing community campaigns for new legislation, volunteering to run blood drives, or cheering on athletes at Special Olympics. In a world where exclusion seems the rule rather than the exception, these young people share regardless of any prejudice. They share successes, they share struggles, they share hopes, fears, they share happiness for each other, no matter what the goal or dream. Perhaps that is why they were such a successful class here. They did this, the STEM Academy, together. Individually, they acquired FBLA State Awards, TSA National Titles, the Gold Award for the National German Exam, the DECA Student of the Year Award, Model UN, Marketing, Science Olympiad, and Computer Fair Awards, Yearbook Best of Recognitions, along with Choir and Orchestra Awards. But together, they are architects of stronger neighborhoods and communities. They are awesome. Class of 2018, kindness is exemplified in the Golden Rule. Treat others as you wish to be treated. The Golden Rule establishes what we dream for you: a shared vision of growth and innovation, keeping in mind the care and welfare of society and all its members. This isn't to say that doing the good things will always be easy or most popular. Often the good provides a rocky and difficult path full of steep cliffs and loose stones to traverse. And yet we know you are capable and prepared for the challenges to come. Please continue to do everything you can do to make this world a better place, because of all of you have made the STEM Academy a better place. Good luck and congratulations to a remarkable group of human beings. Thank you. All right. Now what you've all been waiting for. Mr. Sheehan, will you please join me at the podium and begin to read the names of our graduates? I would also like to invite members of our school board of directors to the stage to hand out diplomas.
Daniel Jeffrey Gao, Ariba Rahman, Caitlin Grace Longenecker, Lane Marie Garber, Julie Ann Greer, Kira Elizabeth Flynn, Akash Ratnadeep Damle, Sarah Amanda Jacob, Maria Maisie Meyer, Meghana Krishna Chigarapati, Alexandra Elizabeth McCurdy, Morgan Lynn Michalski, Julia Ann Schwartz, James George Armstrong, Olivia Lee Williams.
Rishab Harshad Abiyankar.
Hannah Marie Lillis.
Sean Harrison Albright.
Jeffrey Ryan Litsky.
Alia Alou.
Gwenelle Marie Loak. Jacob Robert Allwine.
Robert Hansel Lobe.
Jackson Burke Ambrovich.
Christopher Joseph Lohr.
Anurag Ankathi.
Nicholas Joseph Lubeck. Ryan Joseph Babala.
Margaret Elizabeth Maynor.
Jacqueline Rose Bader.
Sarah Kathleen Maynor.
Mark Lewis Bainbridge.
Nathan Colin Major. Encore Bamazai.
Georgia Ann Martin.
Chloe Blair Beaver.
Samari Alexander Massey.
Bryce Allen Bentley.
Shane Ryan McAvoy. Christina Nicole Bober.
William Brian McGowan.
Patrick Allen Bobko.
Caitlin Nicole McGrinder.
James Reed Boudry.
John Gerard McGrinder III. Michaela Varnier Boyda.
Kimberly Ann McMahon.
Stephen Thomas Britton.
Catherine Randall McSherry.
Talia Lee Brown.
Molly Cecilia McVetti. Dana May Bubka.
Adlai Elizabeth Ann Metzger.
Mia Kohler Buckowicz.
Lydia Paige Mindek.
Alexander Jordan Basterna.
Ryan Hamilton Middlestat. Delaney Elizabeth Carl.
Luke Andrew Moran.
Jacob William Carlson.
Natasha Isabella Morgan.
Joseph William Sister.
Sedan Sumith Nair. Alexander Charles Clapp.
Varun Nair.
Amy Caitlin Clark.
Angelina Francis Neely.
Christian William Connolly.
Timothy Robert Nelson. Juliet Grace Copeland.
Natalie Christina Nicole. Oh, Neptune.
Zoe Lynn Cribbs.
Jack Alexander Newcomb.
Joanna Catherine Cuff.
Alexandra Elizabeth Newman. Alexander Michael DeBundo.
Nicole Rose Oberholzer.
Giancarlo Ian D'Ambrosio.
Neil Thomas O'Brien.
Jenna Mary Dawson.
Chloe Frances O'Donnell. Kelsey Elizabeth Delaney.
John Henry Onderdonk.
Jonathan Peter DeTreville.
Sonia Afshan Poria.
Vaishali Devarakonda.
Gina Nicole Pereno. Marcus Peter Juhadi.
Lily Louise Pivato.
Gregory Vincent Doyle.
Shashira Phillip.
Renee Marie Duplin.
Aditi M. Prabhu.
Justine Emma Duva.
Grace Lavinia Pye.
Garrett Emerson Farmer.
Ashwin Shabrolu Raja.
Serena Halen Fernandez.
Tyler John Reister.
Jack Ryan Flannery.
Stephen Anthony Reif.
Megan Lynn Flexner.
Finn Gustav Riker.
Michael Joseph Faltz.
Tabitha Nicole Rodriguez.
Cyan K. Foster.
Blair Christina Romer.
Madison Sarah Geiger.
Remy Shizuko Roskin.
Nathan Kyle Giordani.
Nicholas Armand Ross.
James William Gorley III.
Evan David Rusnak.
Madison Ann Grenoble.
Noah Michael Sabatish.
Samuel Grisalis.
Svetlana Samanthula.
Srirashmi Gudor.
Jessica Thora Slosser.
Chase Richard Hannick.
Kendall Jean Scott.
Calvin James Hayes.
Jack Lucas Scullin.
Nathaniel Ryan Healy.
Diana May Sears.
Nicholas Philip Hessel.
Vishwa Ajay Shanmugam.
Isabel Grace Hessler.
Kanika Sharma.
Haley Carolyn Hirth.
Haley Lane Shaw.
Samantha Hope Hovis.
Matthew Denning Shen.
Sage Elizabeth Hurley.
Joy She.
Siddesh Iyer.
Noriyuki Shinagawa.
Zachary Scott Jackson.
Harry Heron Sivakumar Pandian.
Rhea Jane.
Jillian Grace Smith.
Yeah, Jillian! Abigail Dajween Johns.
Yeah, Ovia Soundarajan. Yes.
Emily Jasween Johns.
Emily! Drew Kenneth Sponfelner.
Yeah, Drew! Abigail Lee Philomena Johnson.
Yeah, Courtney Ann Specht.
Nicholas Michael Cabot.
Andrew Michael Stahl.
Cole Davis Kakmar.
Nathaniel John Stone.
Andrew David Kahn.
Joseph Ryan Stranin.
Evan Robert Kaiser.
Takozarai Elizabeth Sweetland.
Justin Stanley Karpinski.
Evan Robert Sykes.
Simmerjeet Kaur.
Eva Marie Thielander.
Camille Rita Khalifa.
Lily Abplanelp Thomas.
Justin Dean Kiefel. Yeah,
Rhea Amod Tipness.
Grace Bellarose Kikuchi. Yes,
Devin Ivy Trethaway.
Yes, Anna Julia Kloiber. Yes,
Catherine Marie Tyson. Yes,
Brittany Rose Close. Yes,
Lucy Stanton Udell. Yes,
Alexander James Koblish.
Sydney Claire Verdisha.
McKenna Elizabeth Kovach.
Rohan Pramal Vora.
Isaac Blaze Kramer.
Vineeth Vorganti.
Jean Kwan.
Alyssa Carmen Watts.
James Peter Lavaca.
Grayson James Weaver.
Andrew James Lavin.
Ryan Allen West.
Jack Ryland Lawton.
Natalie Ann Wooten.
Jack Vincent Lear.
Noah Bar Yavel.
Alexandria Lauren Lehman.
Emily Jane Zach.
Morgan Elizabeth Lerario.
Manali Sachin Zope.
Catherine Wong Lee.
Nicholas Elias Zoras.
Audrey Kathleen Liebhart.
At this time, I would like to ask our educational leader, our superintendent, Dr. Emily Lenardi, to please join me at the podium. Dr. Lenardi, I present to you the class of 2018 of the Downingtown STEM Academy. As headmaster, I am certifying to you that this class has completed all Pennsylvania statutory requirements for successful completion of high school in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. If you would, please confer graduation upon these 194 seniors.
Thank you, Headmaster Campbell. Before conferring the diplomas, I'd like to take a moment to offer my sincere and heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2018 and to your parents, guardians, family, and friends. We are so very proud of you and appreciate you taking your academic experience so seriously and continuing the excellence expected here at STEM. It is not by chance that the STEM Academy is ranked number one. Your persistence, hard work, and that of your amazing teachers and administrators, combined with a big dose of family support, are the reason we enjoy such an outstanding reputation around this county, state, and country. Graduates, before you close your eyes this evening, be sure to thank all those who have helped mold you into the men and women you have become. Please know that we all join you in this celebration and wish you unending success and happiness in all that you do. Now, without further ado, will all graduates please rise? By the power vested in me by the Downingtown Board of School Directors, in accordance with the Pennsylvania School Code, the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and the Department of Education, I hereby confer the academic degrees, declaring the class of 2018 as graduates of Downingtown STEM Academy. Graduates, you may turn your tassels. Graduates, please be seated.
Class of 2018, it has been my pleasure to work with you as your class president. We have made many lasting memories in our 4 years together at the STEM Academy. Here's to the lifelong friends we made. I wish you all the best in your future, and I can't wait to see what you will accomplish. Please join me in officially commending the class of 2018 by sending it. Downingtown STEM Academy, please lift your caps. Everyone remember to remove your tassels. On the count of three, let's send it. One, two, three.